Hi everyone, the weather cooperated today at the U.S. Open near Philadelphia, and the golf course showed its teeth in round two as there are only two golfers below par at this point. Let's begin with Tiger Woods, who shot a 73 in round one, which he completed this morning, and then came back with an even par 70 in round two. He's three over for the championship. Rory McIlroy from Northern Ireland was in Tiger's group and was a carbon copy of Woods' 73 and 70. He made four birdies in his second round, including one on the eighth hole after this sensational approach shot. American Billy Horschel played amazingly well today. He became the first player in 21 years to hit every green in regulation in a round at the U.S. Open en route to firing a 3-under 67. He's minus one for the championship. Now, Phil Mickelson had the clubhouse lead overnight at 3-under. He bogeyed the first hole. Check out this, a terrific approach shot on eight, though. He failed to make the birdie from there. He's at minus two overall through nine holes today and is still the leader. For the first time in franchise history, the Calgary Flames will have three first-round draft picks. And to say the least, this is the most important draft in franchise history. General Manager Jay Feaster and his staff have been working hard to prepare for the June 30th draft. They say they're prepared, and Feaster knows what the top priority for his team is.
We have a lot of needs. Obviously, we have to improve ourselves at the center ice position. We have to improve the center ice position both at the top of the lineup in terms of, top two lines. We also have to improve as it relates to third and fourth line center in terms of more size, being harder to play against, being better on faceoffs. I don't know that it's feeling the pressure as much as it is recognizing the importance of it. I mean, that's the importance of this draft is not lost on the organization. And it certainly isn't lost on the management of the organization. I've been to therapy since the end of the season, and it is a rebuild. We are rebuilding. We've acknowledged that, so I guess that's a positive, if nothing else.
Funny man. And the Flames will have to recap the 6th, 22nd, and 28th picks in the first round. The draft is June 30th in New Jersey. After Canada finished 4th at the World Junior Hockey Championships in Ufa, Russia, head scout Kevin Prendergast and goaltending consultant Ron Tugnut's contracts were not renewed. So this week at Hockey Canada's high-performance goaltending camp, Lisa Bowes found one instructor in particular that would like to be considered for Tugnut's job.
He's also a former NHLer, Jimmy Waite, who just completed his first season as goalie coach in Chicoutimi.
I only retired 3 years ago, so coaching goalies, this is what I wanted to do after my career. And also my brother's in Chicago, so me and my brother, we talk a lot and about goalies. And goaltending is our life, and this is something I want to do.
Waite also played for Canada at two World Junior Championships, winning gold in 1988.
We went to Russia and beat the Russians in Moscow, so great memories for that. And every time we see each other on that team, it's always great to see the guys after such a long time.
And when he was a teenager, just like these players, Waite was a highly rated draft pick, eventually selected 8th overall in 1987 by Chicago.
I know exactly what these kids are going through. And I'm sure they're very nervous this week as they want to impress all the coaches. It's always a little bit nerve-wracking, but they're doing a good job. Maybe what's been missing the last few years is good performances at the World Juniors. We had good goalies, but maybe the big games didn't come out. So this is what we're looking to do.
But a higher priority hiring for Hockey Canada is its new head scout for the men's program of excellence. And they tell me that announcement will come down as early as next week. Lisa Bowes, TSN Calgary.
Thanks, Lisa. The Lethbridge Pioneers senior lacrosse team is excited to be hosting the second annual Cindy Grant Memorial Game tomorrow at the Labor Club Arena. Cindy Grant was a longtime and large supporter of Lethbridge lacrosse. She lost her fight to breast cancer in 2011, and this event is to honor her memory. The event will begin at 5 o'clock with a barbecue for $5. The game begins at 7 o'clock versus the Black Falls Silverbacks. Silverbacks a bear, by the way.
Well, thank you. Have you ever heard of a squirrel king?
No.
We're going to show you what it is when we come back. And it takes a bit to get them all entangled. That's a bunch of squirrels right there.
What?
Yeah.